I don't think we really see a lot of pressure in this game. We're used to playing a lot of India-Pakistan games, and every game that India plays is a pressure game. As you can see, the amount of people here, it's just about 70% of the amount of media people that I hear for there for every game. So we are pretty much used to it. It's not about the pressure. I think we should be able to handle it. A game like this, more than who we are playing, it's a T20 World Cup, and we've almost put ourselves in a position where we'll have to win every game from here. So I think that's more important and pertinent. If we knew we would have been all out for 79, we would have tried to reduce the opponents to a lesser score. Unfortunately, we didn't. We had a standard of trying to get the team below 140 and 150, and we thought we'd been doing a fabulous job over the last 3-4 months or whatever, how much of our P20s we played. So from that perspective, I think it was a little bit of a, it was a bad day. So we can't really judge on, they bowled brilliantly. We have to give credit to Santner and Sodhi and McCallum, the way they bowled. And we obviously contributed to their success to a fair bit. So from there on, I don't think it's fair to compare. And with respect to the edge over this game, I don't think anybody has an edge. We start 50-50. Pakistan played wonderfully against Bangladesh. They're supposed to be upbeat. If we can race up and play to our potential, I think we can try and win the game as well. I don't know. I wish I could answer you. But seriously, I don't know. I'm not able to put a finger on one thing and say it is. But on a couple of scenarios, we've been found wanting in the last 2 months where we lost games by a big margin. The one in Pune as well, where the ball did a little bit. The biggest challenge of a tournament like this, apart from the challenge we had, when we played in 2014, we were playing on the same ground in Mirpur. So as far as T20 cricket goes, it's about understanding the game, understanding the dimensions of the ground, the wicket and all that. So whichever teams get used to it can have an edge over in the T20 game. So it's pretty much similar. We moved on from Nagpur to Eden Gardens. So now it's about more conditions, the way the ground operates, the way we'll have to play cricket there. I don't think it's about spinners, playing spin or anything like that. It's about discussing your game plans and revisiting your strategies every now and then. This rivalry is huge, it's very hard to put a finger and say how huge it is. It's probably bigger than Ashes is. So as far as Indians go and the Pakistanis go, they play, I don't think they watch this game as a game of cricket. It's more of a border rivalry. They want to get one up on each other, so there is much more to the particular game in itself rather than the game itself taking center stage. So as far as people are concerned, they put their emotions into the game. It's for the players, it's trying keeping the emotions aside and trying playing the game the best way we can. It's the same approach as I'm talking right now. We managed to keep the pressure of people away from our game preparation and the match itself. So that's been one success point for us. And even leading up to the World Cup, throughout the World Cup, I've always maintained that momentum is very important. We managed to ditch some momentum at Nagpur. We'll have to pick it up from Eden Gardens.